Today, we're talking about paper airplanes that could fly forever. Welcome to Impossible Science. Hey everyone, it's Jason Latimer, world champion of magic, coming to you with another Impossible Science, the show where we take an impossible topic and we bring it to life through science. Now, today's topic, levitation, with paper airplanes that fly forever. Now, what you just saw with the fan, that's a total illusion, but that doesn't mean it's impossible. In fact, today I'm gonna show you how to make one of these. This is a walk-along glider, or forever flyer. Believe it or not, these will actually fly forever, as long as you're willing to walk along the side of it. Now, I'm gonna go over a step-by-step process of how to make them, but if you didn't understand how they work, it would look like magic. So let's cover the four forces of flight. When you throw a frisbee, there's four forces at play: thrust, drag, lift, and weight. Your arm gave the frisbee thrust. That's the force that moves an aircraft in the direction of motion. On a plane, it's the engine, the propeller, or even the rocket that creates the thrust that is moving the plane forward through the air. But drag is the force that is opposite to the direction of motion. Drag is caused by the friction of air molecules, and it's the reason the frisbee slows down. Lift is the force that holds up the frisbee. It's caused by a difference in air pressure between high air pressure below and low air pressure above the frisbee. And weight, which is caused by gravity, that's the force that brings the frisbee back to the ground. Lift is opposite to weight, thrust is opposite to drag. If the force of lift is greater than the weight, the aircraft will rise. If thrust is greater than drag, the aircraft not only moves forward, it speeds up as it goes. So when we're talking about steady flight at a constant altitude, at constant speed, all forces are balanced. All right, now that we understand the four forces of flight, let's apply them towards a paper airplane. Now, a glider doesn't really have thrust, so we're gonna use the other forces. Weight has to do with the paper itself. I strongly recommend the lightest paper you can find. Encyclopedia paper, phone book paper, as long as your parents are okay with that. At the end of the episode, I'm gonna show you how to make this walk-along glider, because it won't work for every paper airplane. It's gonna work for a paper airplane that you can walk alongside of, which will help us with our drag. Which brings me to this. This is gonna help us create lift with an updraft. It's a panel that's 2 feet by 3 feet, and I have a couple paper clips here for a launch pad. And as I walk forward, air is gonna actually blow against this board, and it's gonna keep the paper airplane up. This paper airplane with this panel makes a paper airplane that flies forever. Well, as long as you can walk alongside of it. So let's get this thing going. All right. 3, 2, 1. And you can get them to ascend and descend. All right, now that you know these things can fly forever, let me show you how to make them. Let me break down the four forces of flight so we understand what's happening here. See, weight, it's very important we get a very light piece of paper, because the heavier the paper, the faster it's gonna fly. That means the faster you're gonna have to run behind this thing to keep it up in the air. So I highly recommend very light paper. The next one has to do with drag. That's the air resistance pushing on this plane. That comes down to the shape of how this is made. This air resistance of drag is offset by thrust. Now, normally when you think about a glider, you think there is no thrust, there is no motor. Well, in this case, thrust and lift are connected by this. Now, this board is 2 feet by 3 feet, and I've got two paper clips on the very end here. Now, that just helps us set the paper airplane on top. So when I start walking, I just tip the board forward. That's already in flying position. Now, the paper airplane, it's flying right about here. And why does it do that? Well, this board creates an updraft. As you walk through the air holding this board, you're actually plowing through the air, much like a snowplow. And this is just sitting on that air and it's descending down. Now, the air rushing up is creating lift, but it's also because of its shape. As the air pushes up through here, it's being deflected. And as it's being deflected this way, it's pushing the airplane forward. So you're getting thrust from that panel. You're also getting lift from that panel. So lift and thrust in this case are connected. So now that we understand we have our weight, we have our drag, we have our lift, and we have our thrust. Let me show you how to make it. Now I'm gonna be doing it with cardstock. Again, I highly recommend using tissue paper. I'm gonna be using a cardstock so it's easier to see on the screen. And to do this, you're gonna need some scissors, a pen, and a ruler. The piece of paper that you're gonna need, it needs to be 17 centimeters by 22 centimeters. Now the first fold you're gonna do across this diagonal line here. And then you do it again from the other angle. The next fold you're gonna need to do, it gets a little complicated. We're gonna push in and fold down the triangle across like this. So now that you've folded this spot, see these lines? That's where you're gonna fold next. You're gonna fold up here, and you're gonna fold up here. Now, the next one, once you fold it in, we're gonna fold again on these lines that I've provided here. You fold in there, and you fold in there. Okay? Now, this is where it gets a little tricky. You wanna take these triangles and you wanna fold them down and in. Okay? Then you wanna fold this top triangle, the last remaining piece, down. And if you look closely, there's a little gap in here. And there's a little gap on the other side. You're just gonna tuck these triangles in there. Now I'm rushing through this for you guys, but you want to make this as exact as possible. And when you're done with that section, it's gonna look like this. Once you're there, take this fold and we're gonna flip it over. And we're gonna fold right here. Now, where do I find that fold? It's because this edge is gonna line up with dead center here. You can actually just crimp it and fold right here, and you can see where the center is. And this fold is gonna be right there. And you're gonna do the same to the opposite side. Okay? Making sure. Now that you fold it here, this is actually coming up on the most difficult fold. Once we fold it in like this, we're gonna be folding from the center back to the outside. It's not exactly halfway. You wanna put your finger here at this corner and you want to fold back. This is the hardest fold. So this fold right here, there's a little corner. Take a close look at this. There's a little corner that's coming out right there. You see that spot? So it's kind of a diagonal. And you're gonna do that to both sides. And you get that by putting your finger there and folding it back. You can see that little tiny triangle coming out on the side of it, right there. And it'll look like this, and we're almost done. Because then you're gonna take this and you're gonna unfold it. Now I've put a line here to show you where those folds just came from. Here comes a little bit of cutting here. We're gonna take a ruler, and you're gonna draw a line from the center point here to here. You actually really just need to where it intersects, but I want to show you how to make that line. You really just need to go from here to there, but in order for everybody to follow along at home, it's from the center point of the plane to the corner. And we're going to look at this point right here. We're also going to do it for the other side, so I might as well since my ruler's out. Perfect. And that's the intersection I'm talking about. All right, now grab a pair of scissors. If you don't have adult supervision, have somebody help you with this part. And you wanna cut to that intersection, and then you wanna cut out that inside triangle. Triangle looking thing, actually. It's technically not a triangle, but that's the scientist in me coming out. So you've now cut this piece out of this. One last fold. Now we're gonna create what's called an air break on this paper airplane. We're actually raising the center section, and then we're going to fold here and try to get it to fold midway up this back part. Midway between here and here, we're gonna get it to fold there. So it's bowed up. You see that upwards triangle right there? Another way to do it is to just put your thumb here, peel up here, and crease. You can see it happen already. And that's it. Now to test this ready for flight, you wanna just go ahead and throw it like a regular paper airplane. These little tabs here, you can actually fold up right where the cut is,
And this will help you steer the plane, because what you really want is a plane that's going to fly straight. So go ahead and throw this plane. If it flies to the left or to the right, use your tabs to correct.
And there you have it, a paper airplane that can fly forever. Now, if you didn't know this was possible, this would look like magic. Just remember, levitation's always just a balance of forces. And in this case, as long as you're willing to run behind it, you can make this airplane fly forever. Now, if you do it, let me know in the comments below. And if you like just the idea of taking an impossible topic and bringing it to life through science, make sure you like the video and subscribe to the channel. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything. We're talking about paper airplanes that could fly?
Nope, they can't.
Forever. Or not, doesn't matter. That's not supposed to happen that way.